Do you want to live in a country that grows or not grows? Of course, grow. Because by the country grows, it will also increase our living standard. In this video, I am Aji Kurniawan Yusuf. We're gonna talk about economic growth or productivity. Do you know that the key of rising living standard is continuing increase in average labor productivity? Now, the question is that, how to determine nation's economic growth rate? Usually, we use GDP per person. GDP per person equals to average labor productivity times share of population employed. So, if a country wants to increase GDP per person, of course, the country needs to increase average labor productivity. They also need to increase share of population employed. What is average labor productivity? Average labor productivity is productivity per each worker. It means the GDP divided by number of population employed. And then share of population employed equals to number of workers divided by total population. What determines average labor productivity? There are six factors that determines average labor productivity. First, human capital. Second, physical capital. Third, land and natural resources. Four, technology. Five, entrepreneurship and management. And six, political and legal environment. Let's take a look one by one. First, human capital. Human capital such as talent, education, training, and also skill. People who have larger stock of human capital tend to be more productive than worker with smaller one. Because of that, you have to be enthusiastic in learning this lesson. Second is physical capital, such as machine. If you wash many clothes with machine and without machine, which one is quicker? Of course, if we use washing machine. But how many machine we use has to be adjusted with the number of workers on input. For example, like this. A company has two workers. Without any machine, they could wash 1,000 clothes. And then, the company decides to purchase one washing machine. It will increase the productivity. For example, they could wash 1,200 clothes. Increase 200 clothes. If the company adds one more washing machine, it will also increase the productivity. Because each worker could operate one washing machine. So it will be quicker. For example, it becomes 1,500 units, increase 300 units. Now, if the company add one more washing machine, so the total are 3 washing machines, the productivity could diminish. Why? Because no worker operate that machine, or they need to separate their focus to operate 2 machines directly. For example, they could only produce 1,600 units, only increase 100 units. This is called as diminishing return to capital. Third, land and natural resources. How could you produce something without any resources? Of course, could not. That's why having land and natural resources will make the workers more productive. Four, technology. Of course, new technology will fasten workers to produce goods and services. Fifth, entrepreneurship and management. Having entrepreneurship character is so critical in working. People who have entrepreneurial mindset and could manage their job well will be more productive. And the last is political and legal framework or political and legal environment. Well-defined property rights will encourage people to produce more. The other example, if the political condition is stable, it will also encourage people to be more productive. Is it clear? Now, how to promote economic growth? Of course, we need to increase all determinants of average labor productivity. The government could make several policies to increase human capital. For example, in Indonesia, students need to study at school for minimum 12 years. And then the government also make policy regarding saving and investment, such as investment in bond that gives high return with very low risk. And then support research and development. For example, there will be prize for people who find new research and development concepts. And of course, the government could maintain political and legal stability in a country. To grow, of course, there will be costs that need to be spent. That is trade-off. If you want to grow, that is a cost that you need to spend. What costs needed to grow? First, cost of investing in human capital and also physical capital, such as machine. For example, you have company and then you want to conduct training for your worker, it needs money. You want to purchase machine, it needs money. Second, cost of research and development. Of course, it is not cheap, it is expensive. Third, cost is not always about money. It could be also time. So you need to reduce leisure time to work. So as the conclusion, to make the economy grow, the government needs to increase average labor productivity and share of population employed. How to increase the productivity? Of course, increasing six determinants of average labor productivity: human capital, physical capital, land and natural resources, technology, entrepreneurship and management skill, and the last is political and legal environment.